emphasis on the individual in society rather than society itself is more important. Writers and social commentators have regaled us with their thoughts of diet and food. Samuel Johnson, for example, wrote, "A cucumber should be well sliced and dressed with pepper and vinegar and then thrown out as a good Edward Lear's quote from the album of Pussycat, "Dine on the Nymphs and Slice of Quinkles, the Egg, the Lunch of the Spoon, and Hand in Hand on the Edge of the Sand, they dance by the Line of the Moon," reminds us of a female character, Letitia Crawford, with a vigor of living, who used the most compelling combination of foods to create the most disgusting effects. People have peculiar views on food. For example, my mind will only accept a fish if it doesn't smell the taste of fish. She would agree with Edward Lutyens, who said, "This piece of coal passes all understanding." You are, of course, the product of your families or your own cooking. Franz Lipovitz, an American commentator, pointed out, "Large named parents are acceptable food only to those in touch as deeply as at least." Henry Miller commented, "Americans can eat farm fish, provided you sprinkle it liberally with ketchup, mustard, chili sauce, or any other condiment, which destroys the original flavor of the food." And always wonder how many of them used to say that. So J.D. Miller, the famous American humorist, pointed out, "I went into a McDonald's yesterday and said, 'I'd like some fries.' The girl at the counter said, 'You want fries?'" Of course, chips, pizzas, and takeaway carrots are said to be the staple foodstuffs of students, but I know the normal students are different. They have more sophisticated tests. For example, our linguistic students ordered an entire meal in French, which really surprised the waiter, who is a Chinese restaurant. Our students now spend a considerable time at Starbucks. They're up there in the offices. But why the proliferation of Starbucks? Perhaps it's because Finnish coffee tastes like water that is mixed in down the wet sleeve. Perhaps it is because students can't face eating in the evening, because they can't cook very well, it does take effort to open to these, or they've experienced at the end of an academic year clearing out the fridge that looks like a robot. For those students who have lived at home whilst completing their age in COVID, their food may depend on their mum or dad or father's cooking. I'm sure that if, like my family, some children are vegetarian and some are not, the daily chore of concocting dishes that both may eat becomes very stressful. In fact, my youngest daughter gave up being vegetarian when she started to have to cook for herself, and observers would wonder whether what was on the plate at the beginning of the meal or then they were off. As students, it's commonplace not to wash any dishes, cups or plates for as long as possible, even to the end of the academic year. Students have been meant to keep this up for so long that when thirsty, they get out their yards again for a clean cup rather than wash a pesky mug which is now sitting alongside us by the sea. Some students can boil, and this makes them friends with everyone, especially if they can cook meals emanating from different countries. As Alistair Goldman said, "Tomatoes and oregano made Italian, wine and pepper made French, turkey made Prussian, lemon and cinnamon made Greek, soy sauce made Chinese, and garlic made good." So why the concentration on food as a theme of support sector? From time immemorial, food has been used in celebrations as a major contribution to our rituals for celebrating success. And I'm sure that eating food with friends and family will be a small but significant part of your day to day. Like all of us here, I feel very honored to be standing in front of our graduates, who quite likely should be the focus and reason for our celebrations. Their success makes us very proud. I'm sure we'll all clap on today as being a reflection of our graduates' success here at the Mall, but also the start point for success in their learning and career paths in years to come. And if you are today, remember what Frank Lloyd once said. The golden rule for reading the menus, you can't pronounce it, you can't hear it. Our guests, deans and members of the faculty, ladies and gentlemen, by the power as invested in him, the Chancellor of the Committee, all those candidates whose names appear in the award for him, including those in absentia, to the degrees, diplomas and other awards at the University. Learns
foundation moving forward, skills that have been gained, and the main skills employment forms chaired by the mayor, a certain Boris Johnson, with whom we share platforms, were very on the same side. A freedom of the City of London is a fellow of the London Historical Society and of the Royal Society of Arts, and also an honorary fellow at Bristol University, where for over 20 years he and I were close colleagues in the history department, where he was an inspiring teacher and a volcano of energy. To a man with a hammer, everything was up in the air, and remember guidance at the department identifying several limits and enthusiastically flattening them with our hand. The first thing he did, as I recall, was to knock on the wall, an internal wall, deliberately, to improve access from the secretary's office to a private appointment. But he didn't get enough, I can tell you, by going in the TV, because I'm not getting a dinner, and I still have a really animal dignity. Pulling it through your mind, maybe you get shadows in London. Now, I thought of my van, not even serious. I have your dean, Matthew East, Cassie, called Plantable from Cool. It's fitting that the man of Glenn Hopkins Musical Gifts should be honoured by a Chancellor and Vice Chancellor, in the presence also of the distinguished figure of Dr. Christopher Life, Lord Wallace, who for many years MP for Harbour was produced to keep in Cardiffshire, a country that once always had a Glenn Hopkins as its MP. I've often felt that Dyne's migration to London has been a loss to public affairs in Wales. I want to manage what I see as vitality, dynamism, and generosity of spirit, exercise not on the mantle of Thames, but the Taff, and for the benefit of many Taffs. It's only when you have a lot to say that you leave a lot unsaid, but that must suffice as a flame of Guy Hopkins' kaleidoscopic range of activities. Is there any way here? Let's go. The Runo team in every league of Juliet, when she came in there after death, and after the day of Hopkins. Johnson, at his first congregation of the Sons of London 8 before ceremonies and humans were ordered, he was called McGannon. I therefore present to you Professor Guy Hopkins for admission to the honorary degree of Doctor. It's a great pleasure to be amongst friends and former colleagues, fellow musicians as well. Your Vice Chancellor, I'm delighted to be with you first, although we haven't yet formed a band, but I think that this is changing some of the past, so I think we'll be emerging from this. But let me just say a brief few words of thanks to Gareth for his very generous words. I was tempted to say unusually generous words. We worked together for 20 years. I don't recall saying anything like that on
completely saving it up. But I'm all about Gareth. Capital is, of course, a very great contribution to our Shisarami, not least the filter districts, both the Welsh rugby and Welsh choral singing. Presumably, in principle, that if you can't outplay your opponents, you can certainly outsing them. It's also a particular pleasure to be part of this ceremony, this particular ceremony, with a range of degrees in civil and mechanical, building services engineering, QS, EIT, mechatronics, aerospace. And you may be wondering, why a historian would say this, and with such a talent of humanity? Well, for one thing, I'm practicing for next week, which I'm doing exactly the same thing as civil graphics. More important, there's an expression of historical material from the origin of this university as the South Wales and Monmouthshire School of Mines, whose engineering, science, and technology is such an enormous contribution to the common good. And it's not the present and the future, because if there ever was a time, when in Egypt, a range of key engineering and technology skills represented today, it's now, whether sufficient construction systems, energy conservation, alternative energy systems, fuel efficiency, these are some key competences that will enable us to be sustainable in the future. My own university shares with enthusiasm for your degree programs, which are building blocks for future technology. And that's why I'm so proud to be an honorary graduate chancellor of this university, because we are so similar in mission, aspiration, and the crucial work of widening participation and social justice. I have to say, I'm very struck with your university crest, which I'm sure you all are. In case you haven't studied yet, which I should have, I would encourage you to do so. The design is called Achievement of Arms. The main shield and symbolism are clever alignment of old and new, local and global. The gold chevrons of Estimat Gulldad, last king of Dunorga, just opposed, in composite perhaps, symbolically connected with a gold computer ferrite memory store matrix, representing the technology and the history of the university, and two dragons, Wales and Orient, local and global, co-located with the instruments of heavy industry, pickaxe and copper, symbolizing the applied nature of the university's courses, a richness of history, the relevance of present work. By contrast, by the way, all we have on our crest is a couple of boats and a bit of tents. And I hope that's not a symbol of global warming. So, in accepting this honor today, at least I have a great crest to go with it. Chancellor, I said I'd be brief. Once again, my sincere thanks, and also those of my wife, Jane, from the right, for joining here today. There's one other family reason, by the way, which you are not passing very well. Because 60 years ago, my mother graduated from Barry College, with whom this university merged. So it's very important for me to hear. And so therefore, let me leave you the words of the motto which was on that college's crest, and is now on yours. The words of the Rhondda miner and poet Ben Bowen. A reminder that industry and culture, technology and education are inseparable. Copiapus in me. Remember to learn, to live. I know you've learned so much here from the University of Dunorga. I know you will live well as a result. My thanks and best wishes to you all. Your family and me are full to be at and a devoid.
Chinese cryptography in recognition of program of work entitled Improvements in Direct Offshore Induction Projects. The program of work is carried out under the direction and supervision of Dr. Marcel Chen, Professor Phil Whitten, Faculty of Advanced Technology. Ming Fong Chao, in recognition of program of work entitled Packet-Based Control for Medical Control Systems.
Hopkins.
Chancellor, I present to the congregation those candidates to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Science in Civil Engineering. Agitation is your pathology.
Thank you.
Should be above. Any of you would wish to, or indeed may have to, change direction with the course of your career. How different to so many of your predecessors 30 or 40 years ago. There was then so often a life expectation of doing the same or similar work throughout your life. An expectation frequently achieved. Career changes during life will become more and more the norm. Our programs are designed not just to impart specialist knowledge, but to teach transferable skills that will enable you to be useful, adaptable to employees from day one and every day after that. Whatever the demands in life, you can have a basic foundation, coupled with your experience thereafter, to meet that demand. We hope that you will continue to search out for new ideas and new skills to enhance your personal and professional development and become true lifelong learners. Today, we're all uplifted by your achievements and hope that this celebration will be something that you will look back on with pride and pleasure. For the coming years. Remember, there are three types of people. Those who make it happen, those who watch it happen, and those who wonder what happened. Be sure that you are one of those that make things happen. Don't forget us, keep in touch, and do spread the word about the excellent times we've had in the hall. Remember that you are now our ambassadors wherever you may be. I wish you good health, safe journey home, and a successful journey in life. Thank you very much.